First halacha is when we blow a shofar, on Rosh Hashanah, the halacha is you have to blow standing. Okay? People have to do it while they're standing. What they do is the Chazan comes near the Bima and he has the shofar put up in front of him. Some people have a good advice is that the person who blows a shofar should always carry another shofar with him. Right, come prepared in case one of them gets, I don't know, either wet or he can't blow with it anymore and he wants a different shape for the mouth to blow better. So then he has another shofar on the side. I saw many people do interesting things. They have all types of things in order to dry the shofar and whatnot. Okay. Here is another halakha. Before we blow the shofar, the halakha is that they make a bracha. The person who blows the shofar has to make two brachot. First day of Rosh Hashanah, he makes two brachot. One bracha he makes is lishmoa kol shofar. Another bracha he makes is shehechiyanu. Okay? When he says shehechiyanu, that is for the blowing of shofar for the that we came to that time, that Hashem gave us an ability to fulfill his mitzvah again. You make a shehechiyanu. Now the shehechiyanu, when the chazan blows, is an obligation is the first day only. Okay. Now when the chazan blows, if he blows for somebody already, and there's somebody else comes and I didn't hear the shofar yet, make another two brachot. Why not? Make again the shmoa kol shofar and also shehechiyanu. That is the halakha.
My grandfather, I say shehechiyanu.
Sure, of course you do that. First day you make two brachot for him. Okay. Now for women, we do not make a blowing the shofar, we don't make the brachot at all because they are exempt from the mitzvah. There's no obligation. It's a timely mitzvah, the mitzvah associated with time. And the halakha is any mitzvah associated with time, the women are exempt. Now there's no difference if he makes the bracha. Let's say he himself is alone, right? Let's say your grandfather wants to blow the shofar himself and he knows how to, he makes two brachot as well. Why not? Okay. Okay, then the following halakha. When they blow the shofar, they have to blow three times. Now we know there's three kolot. There is three kolot that we have the right is to hear. I think the proper thing is to hear nine kolot. The question is, we have a safek which ones they are. So we go ahead and we do tashrat, tashrat, tashrat. And then we do tashat, tashat, tashat. And then we do tarat, tarat, tarat. So all total you have is 12, 9, and 9. So you have a total of 30 kolot to fulfill the deolaita. Then you have the kolot drabanan, which we have machloket. According to Sfaradim, they have the following in Hagari, that the Chazan blows the shofar also during the quiet Shmona Esre. The Ashkenazim don't have Shulchan Aruch and the Ashkenazim don't have Sheminach. They say specifically that when they play a quiet Shmona Esre Musaf, there's no Tkiyot blowing at all. Chazarat Hashat, in the repetition, they have blowing the shofar. And after Shmona Esre, they blow another 30 calls. So they blow 30, 30, and 30. It's just we do it, they do it after Musaf, we do it during Musaf. Twice, one time before after Kriyat HaTorah, that is to be Yotzei Deoraita, and then you have Tkiyot Drabanan, rabbinical Tkiyot, which you do 30 of them, right, you do during quiet Shmona Esre Musaf, and then you do 30 of them during the loud Shmona Esre Musaf, and then afterwards by Kaddish, they say another blowing to make it a total of 100 kolot. To make a total of 100. They blow another tashat, tashrat, tashat, and tarat. And then afterwards what they do is to make it 101 after the alenu, they blow a teruah gedolah just to blow again. Okay. Then, as far as the blowings of the shofar, how this is supposed to be and what should be is not so difficult. Some people have to know this, especially those who blow the shofar. They blow the shofar when you blow the first time. And you go tashrat, your tkiyah has to be long enough as long as you do your shvarim truah. Meaning, if your shvarim truah, right, 9 turmitin you have, tut 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 tut, 9. So these 9 and tut 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 have to be equal on time. Now these all together have to be one long tkiya. Tu. Okay? When you do the shorter one, tu only, then the tu has to be shorter too. Don't have to make it too long. You have shoes, you go, you hear the chazan, he takes out the shofar, the baal tkiya, tu. A longer alarm clock, I guess. Some people like to have a smaller alarm to wake up, some have longer. Nothing against it, but lifi halakha, you don't have to do this. Another important thing is people, when they blow the shofar, they should not go to they it sounds like, you know, you're in a shop, body shop, when they're fixing cars, right? Zoom, 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 right? So that is not proper, because you have to finish the code. A lot of people, they go to no, not to. No, there's no what's it. You gotta go to, stop it. It has to stop. You have to do more. Okay. Now, another halakha we have is like this: is when a person blows a shofar.
What's wrong with the room? What's wrong with
it? A lot of people. What's wrong with it is when they try to do three shvarim. When they try to do the shvarim, the trua, the shvarim, shvarim. When they do shvarim, toot. When they go toot. It connects all three together.
So you are
at a complete loss.
What if you separate them? That's a problem.
Then you waste another few seconds. I don't know if that counts. You gotta go toot.
But the room is part of the last tkiya. So you room. You can do that.
I don't know. I don't know all the details exactly what, when, where. We have to go through the halachot and see what's a problem, what's not a problem. But you're supposed to have them separate. Or everything, you know, tkiya is tkiya, shvarim is shvarim, trua is trua, the way it's supposed to be. Now, one person blows the shofar. If he was not able to finish the tkiyot by himself, I don't know, he broke down in the middle. You bring another guy to blow, continue blowing. This one bracha is good for 100 people who know how to blow. But anyhow.
Start over or
no, continue from where he is.
If I screw up, now, I can pick it over.
He says the following. Now, after these halakha and Shulchan Aruch, also important to know that it's just like Birkat Kohanim, right? If there's only Kohen, one Kohen in the shul, and he's sure of himself that he could return back to his prayer. After interrupting, right? After he could always come back, if he plays a praise as a chazan, then how will be is he's allowed to pray and blow the shofar as well. But if he knows that he's going to blow the shofar and he won't be able to return back to his prayer the way he's supposed to be, then if he doesn't know how to go back to his prayer, then he's not allowed to. You have two separate people blowing the shofar the way it is. Okay, now, one second. Okay, another custom they have, the Ashkenazim have, is that they have a person standing next to the Shotokea. He says, Tkiya, Tut, Shvarim, Trua, Tut. They tell him what to do. They have shitting. Preferably, they say a person who tells them what to supposed to be a big Talmid Acham. If the rabbi of the shul is there, he's supposed to be the one to do it. Another important halacha which people have to know, those people who take money to blow the shofar on Rosh Hashanah, in order to pray on Shabbat, Yamim Tovim, right, to be a mitargem, to give shiurim, what not? The halacha is, Shulchan Aruch says straightforward, Eno roe meoto sachar siman bracha, you do not see any bracha from that payment, whatever you get. So you have to make sure that, you know, when you pay the rabbi, you don't pay him for the Rosh Hashanah and Yom Kippurim. What you pay him for is for the weekly time that he spends in order to run the shul for you. Yes.
What if his cousin Friday afternoon and then the whole Yom Tov? You can, before Yom Tov, the Mincha.
Oh, you tell him that was expensive Mincha. But anyhow, Rabbi Hananya ben Akash Omer.
You do that?
I guess you can.
Can you say it's my brother?